Okay, so just one more thing to discuss here, and that is, what do we do if the inequality is greater than or equal to zero instead of greater than zero? Well, we would proceed with the problem the same way. This would be greater than or equal to zero. This would be greater than or equal to zero. We would go through all the same steps in solving the problem, except when we get to this point, we have to do one more investigation. We need to investigate the boundaries of these intervals. Should all these intervals really be open intervals, or should some of them include the boundaries? In other words, should we use square brackets here? Well, let's go look at the picture and see what happened. Well, in the picture, you can see that where the function is greater than or equal to zero goes, it's greater than or equal to zero up to negative two, but not including negative two because it's not defined there. So that means we leave this interval open. We use a round parenthesis. So that is correct. Now, what about near negative 1? Well, near negative 1, we see that the function is not defined at negative 1, so it doesn't make sense to say that it's greater than or equal to 0 here, or to say anything about that function there. So we have to leave it open. We can't talk about its value at negative 1, so we leave this open. What about at 0? Well, at 0, if we look at the picture, here the function is equal to 0. And 0 is greater than or equal to 0, and so this is included. So that is one adjustment that we need to make. We need to make this a square bracket here to indicate that 0 is part of the solution. What about this number over here, the 1? If I look at the picture, the function's not defined at 1, and so it doesn't make sense to say it's greater than or equal to 0. So again, we leave the interval open. And so this is what the answer would look like for the inequality greater than or equal to 0. We would have it all the same except we put a square bracket here. Now, we appealed to the picture to make these, to draw these conclusions. How could you tell the answers just by looking at the expression? What if you didn't have the graph on hand? Well, you can still do it. It's fine. You just have to plug in these numbers and check. So just take negative 2, plug it in here. What do you get? Does this become a true statement or not? Well, you'll see if I plug negative 2 into this expression, the denominator becomes 0. Notice this term right here, this factor becomes 0. And so that means the whole thing is undefined. So that means it's not greater than or equal to 0. So that means we don't include the negative 2. What about the negative 1? Same thing. Makes the denominator 0. So the whole thing is undefined. So this is not a true statement. So I don't include the negative 1. I leave a round bracket. What about 0? Well, if I plug in 0, the whole thing becomes equal to 0 because the numerator is 0. It's not undefined. It's perfectly defined. It's equal to 0. And that is a true statement. 0 is greater than or equal to 0. So I include the 0. And what about 1? Well, 1 makes the denominator 0. It's undefined. So it is not part of the solution. So we leave an open bracket here, round parentheses. So that's a way to do it just by looking at the function. Now, I just want to point out that you have to be careful to do this before you've canceled any common factors. If you cancel common factors, you may hide the fact that the function's not defined at negative 2. If we were to cancel these, now you wouldn't see that. So make sure you look at the unsimplified form, the uncanceled form, when you go and make these investigations at the boundaries of these intervals. So this is how we would handle the problem if it was greater than or equal to.